patterns on this side.
Huge amount of wood debris at the entrance to that pond. Also over on this pond, so that's all coming from the riverside, wetlands around the edges. Beach face there, pretty narrow, less than 10 meters, and then the sand flat. We've got some swashbuckles and another gigantic accumulation of wood debris up on the wetlands and in this pond area. And as we come up, we're seeing a parking lot on the upper part of the frame,
wow.
And then this whole lagoon complex in behind that's filled with wood. So it looks like the wood comes in and is pushed by southeasters up into that, or southerlies up into the northern
along
ends of
the side of where the road comes.
Now we picked up rubble all associated with the road.
Let's
zoom in a bit.
The river is actually quite silty. It's field grass below us, but not on the far bank.
Boat launching facility, rubble all the way up to the shoreline here. See all the wood accumulated next to the bridge abutment. There's lots of old pilings down there. The bridge system. And again, it actually looks like maybe this wood comes up in storm surges.
There's the storm burst, storm ball.
That gets pushed in by the southerly wind, so it may come in from the marine entrance here and pushed up.
Strange.
So there's a wood control structure on that wetland area. This is a dike wetland area. It looks like
open though.
Looks to me like it has not been breached, and you can see it's been really
and it also
cool.
Looks like it's had large amount of debris placed along the channel.
Along the shoreline.
It's not quite natural looking. Logs there.
Very extensively
looks like restoration of tidal flow.
I'm going to do an overview of the marsh there, or former marsh. You can see the old drainage patterns in there, and then the attempts to ditch and drain this system. And so there are dikes along the shore. Looks to me like they've been trying to breach some of these things.
It's rather a box that
but the main tidal channels are not breached. My sound's okay, and the power's good.
I look out of the upper marsh there.
We're 16 minutes into our tape.
Yeah, I just about ate my microphone with the cracker, so.
Yeah, the power buttons.
Hope it's still working okay. Vehicle tracks.
Will we be able to drop down at all? Maybe to about 500 or 600.
There's
600.
A flood control or the gate on the main channel at the bottom of that boat.
As we come along here, there's definitely old tidal channels here. I'm trying to see whether they still have the control structures on them.
Cranberry fields in the back. They show up as red.
There's a parking lot, boat launch area. Boy, there sure are a lot of those. Public access to the coastal zone is really good here. We've got lots of pilings, probably associated with old booming.
It's a funny looking ditch.
There's a rubble along the road, so there's road filled here.
Organic debris, old pilings, a beautiful old
road fill in the back shore, then picking up this other wetland.
And the road goes along the side of the riverbank.
We're going to have to go along that inner channel.
slightly round, probably sedge, tipped over.
Yeah, if you could go down the channel. And totally. And don't cut it quite the end, because I can't film it, because it's the end of the sun. Now we can go. Thank you.
There's a log accumulations on the upstream end of this island. Corner.
it's all vegetated with trees.
Bars all vegetated.
It's all cut bank riprap.
And that is a whole bunch of pilings all along the bar bank there.
It almost looks like riprap.
It's not, though. It's just a
cut bank.
That is a...
slowly working up up the Coquille River.
Oh dear. And great shadows from the trees across the bank there. Pretty much continuous.
How much further, sure?
Trees and shrubs.
Incredible.
red channel with a natural riparian, and it's like a natural channel.
Are we pretty close, Sherry, or? Where it looks like we've got some erosion going on in the bank, right inside of frame, but shades. Right now, the height of those trees casting a shadow, sometimes a quarter of the width of the river.
Now, there's that blue tarp.
Yeah, the three quarters in the direct sunlight. Large subparallel ditch going along in the back shore. You can just catch that. It's so thin here, it almost looks like it. I was going to say old rail bed, but it's a ditch. A ditch.
Former natural drainage there. It's all tree. It's probably got some dam at the bottom. This side channel there is
coming to a little village here.
Natural drainage, but it's dammed.
Some cut
there's
I don't see
riverbed.
Shoreline, tiny
pilings, little clumps of pilings here and there. There's a boat launch.
Looks like a park,
parking area.
Boat launching ramp and small wharf.
Floating dock there.
Shoreline, the riverbank looks stable, and
meander there. cut off from the main channel.
Scarf cut right on the boat in this river, so not much
grace.
But obviously,
that's an osprey nest on the top
this
of that.
This is loving material.
Boulder.
There's riprap in there. There's a wooden bulkhead.
Cattle
and all
bridge.
Of a sudden, we're into course.
Oh, there's
loving material, riprap all along the shoreline
wells.
Here, associated
just
with a dike. So there's boulder cobble, shovel, and landfill sort of material. Some log debris, pretty continuous dike
like
all through here. Control structure there. It looks like it's been opened now, so the control structure is open.
Interesting.
The end of the dike system. Dikes on both sides of that creek. It's been, talk about being
there.
Marginalized.
Surrounded
that's a great
salt
example.
Marsh.
Cut bank on the river deposits, old pilings down there. Sort of an old industrial area. High tension wires just went across. So there's big old wharfs here.
And docks and pilings here.
You can see the residences in here now. Some of landfill, those are landfills. Rip rubble.
Here's some rows of old pilings.
And we've got old pilings along the shore. There's old wood bulkheads. Try to zoom in here. We're up high because of concerns about a wildlife
it
area.
Looks like bedrock, not concrete. There's some cranberry fields right in town.
30-meter wide mud flat.
Docks there. Ooh, an old sawmill.
There's intermittent landfill. Most of it's vegetated bank.
Log sort of some type.
Areas. But then there's the odd old piling structures all
docks
over the place. So
down.
This is an old mill. Good example of old piling structures associated with a mill. And many of the mills are probably gone. This is the wildlife refuge area. So we're staying up here and offshore.
Well, there's
structures
definitely
look more like groins than anything else. May have had some side decking on them.
Lower marsh.
It's a natural marsh system. This looks like it's actually
so
never been diked or drained.
They
missed this one.
Salt marsh elevation.
Deposits of wood debris on there associated with storm surges.
Rolls and rolls of pilings.
A big up flat in the back shore. And so this is all the wildlife refuge. I'll try to shoot forward here because as we come around the
look
corner,
cool
it's the sun's sort of following us.
Listening
we've got
sun.
A little sand flat down below.
Or this cool round
big expanse of complicated wetland and mud flat area.
Looks like that.
Decking there.